Well, hello there, neighbor, and welcome to another installment of our Education Hour Home Huddle Edition. It's good to be with you again today as we take time to share in life together, to read God's Word and talk about it, to pray together, and to bless each other. Our world today might not resemble too much of that Mr. Rogers neighborhood, but this is all the more reason for us to live as good neighbors. Part of being a good neighbor is taking time to listen and to share with each other. So let's do that now. Take some time to go around the room and share with each other. Our text for today is all about neighbors. Now, Jesus tells a short story in Luke chapter 10 about what it means to be a neighbor. And I want to give you a little bit of background on some of the characters you're going to hear in this story to hopefully help it make more sense for you in its context. The first character is the lawyer. He's the one actually asking Jesus the question. Well, the lawyer is not a lawyer like we conceive of it. The lawyer would have been part of that group called the Pharisees. He was an expert on God's law from the Old Testament and would have been responsible for teaching it, for administering the law, and for understanding it. So he comes to Jesus with a question about the law, wondering what it means to love neighbor. Well, and Jesus tells that story, and in the story you get some more characters. You have a priest and a Levite. Those were the church workers in Jesus' day. These are also guys who would have known a lot of scripture and would have been expected to do the right thing. And then you have that character called the Samaritan. Now, Samaritans and Jews, the Jews were those Pharisees, the lawyers, the people who Jesus came to. Jews and Samaritans shared a common ancestry. But a while back, the Samaritans had fallen away from their faith and gone and married people outside of the community. Now, in Jesus' time, Jews and Samaritans did not get along. Jews saw Samaritans as people who were less than, people who were sinners by virtue of their birth. They didn't associate with them at all. You could probably think of different groups today who don't really spend time together or who don't get along. I hope this gives a little bit of understanding as you jump into the text. But go ahead and do that now. Read this story from Luke chapter 10 and take time to talk about what Jesus was showing the lawyer, about what God is showing us. If we're honest with ourselves, we were that half-dead man along the road. We were dead in our sin, beat down and stripped by Satan and the world. But Jesus showed compassion on us. We have been healed by his death on the cross, where he poured out his blood for us like wine. Then he brought us into his inn, the safe house of his church. And Jesus has made us alive. Because of that, we want to go out and bring life to our world. So let's pray for that. Let's pray this week, giving thanks to God for his rescue of us when we were lost, when we were dead. And then let's pray for God to show us who in this world might need a neighbor, and that he might send us to be neighbors to them. Take time now to pray. actions speak louder than words. But oftentimes, the words that we speak affect and reflect our actions. So let's speak words now to each other to encourage the kind of action God would have us take. Go around the room now and bless one another with these words. Well, thank you for participating in this time of devotion again this week. Just like our lawyer friend from Luke, there's a lot of good questions that we have for Jesus. And we need to continually hear from him in order to make our paths straight and to follow in his footsteps. So why not hear from him again? Remember, all you have to do is share, read, talk, pray, and bless. Have a great week. God be with you.